How are you guys doing?
Good.
I was very interested that I'm speaking in front of a church group or anything. I'm not the type of person who speak or anything like that. But because me and Tom, we go back since 2006, 2007. She used to be my Tai Chi teacher. So yeah, I learned everything twice a week. I was the star pupil. I learned, try to learn everything as much as I can. So, but yeah, like we were talking. Actually, I'm part of a street ministry. Well, not a street ministry. I just like to go minister to people in the streets. So I hit up Hastings, here you got Chinatown. I used to go as much as I can about every day, but I'm very busy lately. So yeah, I've seen people get their eyesight restored, deaf, hear. And just people going back to Jesus, and it's amazing, because I never thought I'd be doing this, especially right now, just sharing a testimony, right? Because I grew up Catholic, and so now back in 97, I saw Jesus, and because I started reading the Bible, and the more I did, I didn't know why I started reading, so back in 97, that was July 3rd, I saw Jesus walking towards me, because I was halfway half asleep, because I saw my Bruce Lee posters, saw my TV, and I saw Jesus in a white robe walking towards me, and he just whispered something in my ear, and then I never saw him leave, so he stayed with me, and then the next night, he visited me in a dream. It was, he was standing right here, and in front of me was water, and he says, come for a walk. And I gave him up like, dude, I can't walk. And he gave me this stuff like, I'm Jesus. So I am like the whole entire water. It wasn't ice, but it was just kind of pure glass. Like, he was talking to me about life, about him, how he's the way, the truth, and the life. And I didn't want to be rude, like, I don't know. But I was like looking more at the creatures down below, because I saw the whales, the dolphins, and everything else. They were giving praise to Jesus. They just wanted to go up. They just wanted to give him worship. And then at that end, the corner, that was the devil. He was speaking about death and where you're gonna go after. It sounded so seducing. It's like, and you can't resist it. It was like a magnet just keeps drawing. And I started sinking. Right? So, and basically, what Jesus was trying to tell me, that the parable was even the devil can speak something which sounds so true, but it leads you to death. And Jesus was the way. So, that was 97. So, I started to go in a camp group. Youth for Christ, that's what they're called, right? So I was excited, I was happy for Jesus, and I went there, it was fun, but then the leaders would speak right after. After they spoke, after the camp, we were right outside for a 20-minute break, and talk about drugs, talk about women. So I got turned off. So all I thought in my head was, Jesus maybe was just imagination. So I started to look into something else. Since when I was with Jesus, I had dreams that he'd take me up to heaven. And you know those indoor surfing that they have now? Back in 97 when they didn't have it, an angel took me up and said, here, we have a new game we're going to try out. I want you to try it out. So I tried it out first. So before it all happened here. So anyways, fast forward. I was, like I said, I was looking for something else. So I converted to Buddhism. I left Catholicism, I left Jesus. So I started, that's one of the reasons why my head is shaved. And one of the reasons is because it used to take me half hour to do my hair. So it got shorter, so I shaved it all off. Less work, better, right? So, but the only thing is, when I was at the temple, we had to chant three names. Obviously that was demonic. I still couldn't say that. You have to give your life, dedication, the way you speak to this three demons. I couldn't say it. In my head, it was so, I gave my life and dedication to the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. There are three things that we have to say. I still kept declaring it, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. I didn't know why. And so I got into that. And then I started getting to New Age. I started getting to witchcraft. First started off with tarot cards. And then mediums. I put people into mediums. And the stuff I used to do for them, you'd hear a chair, like an empty chair, someone sitting down, like heavenly. And candle magic. I need to have witchcraft teachers. I still have tattoo embedded, like right here, of the enemies. So I know it's pretty high level of witchcraft doing everything. Right? So this was basically from 2003, it went on until about 2008. And about 2009, actually, so I kept doing all that. And I'd call on just anything demonic. I had all that power. And 2009, it wasn't going so well. I had an ex-girlfriend that we broke up with for 6 years. Then I lost my job. And everything just started going downfall, right? And I just started thinking in my head, like, what's going on? I thought I knew God because I was raised Catholic, because I had the idea of Him. I had Buddhist wisdom because I thought, you know, like, how life functions and everything, and power from the enemy, but that wasn't it. So I started researching, God, I don't know what I'm doing, if you're real, come for life. And all of a sudden, I heard on YouTube, I saw Chris Collins' video, I Will Rise. For me, I hate Christian music because I thought they were lame.
Yeah.
But when I first played that song, for some reason, that just hit me. I just started crying. Like, it's different. It's not of sadness, but it's like a longness, emptiness. Like you kind of feel like, son, I know you were looking for me, and here I am. I present myself to you. Mm-hmm. So after that, I just started doing a lot more research. I wasn't pure Christian. I didn't give my life to Jesus. So I was saying, 50-50. I said, all right, I'll follow Jesus. Then I said, I'll do other stuff. Because I thought, using Jesus' name, you can use the tarot cards, you can do all of that. And so I started, you know, going around again, going dating, and it just went on until about 2011. Because I thought that was it. I thought, if you knew Jesus, you're good. You go to church, you're good. I didn't even have a home church yet. I went to a Baptist church, the one in Lundell, Gilbert, just everywhere, just to be church hopping, right? Trying to find God. And there just came from my life in 2011, in summertime. And I said, oh, God, I don't know what I'm doing. I honestly don't. I just leave myself. I'm all in. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm on my knees just begging humbly, just give myself. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. So whatever you want me to do, I'll give 100%. And so I just started reading Bible for some reason. I just started to listen to Christian music, and there's this guy named Minister. He used to be a secular rapper, the guy named the Minister. And I actually shared with his testimony. I emailed him back and told him what his music's done to me. He actually has my testimony online. So he's got the song called Nothing But the Blood of Jesus. So I just be blasting that the entire time. And then I just started going up, basically, I started giving my life to Jesus. And summertime, and then the winter time came, and that's when I started going out to hit the streets. It was -4, so I just did from Matthew 25:35-40 to the city. So I'd go around 11:30 at night, go out, get blankets, get food, by myself. And a few people go with me, then they were just to feel good, but they weren't in it for the real reason. Yeah, so I just find people sleeping in the back alleys and the streets, and it really broke my heart. So basically, the Father was trying to show me that if you can love them, then you see me. If you can see love through them, you see me. Right? So I just learned to love people first. And then people started to notice that I was going out there ministering to people. I wasn't ministering. I was being charitable so people would donate. So they see me. They see me as this nice person. But I hated it, right? I don't want people to see me because when I give my life to Jesus, I want them to see Jesus, not me. So pray for I just want people to know that you are real. So I just prayed for a gift of healing, and just met some brother online, because he has a YouTube video online, and I didn't know it was Metatown, because I was part of this group called the Elijah Challenge, healing ministry, and I want to take a break, because they said they know someone from Seattle that does this, so I want to go look him up, see if I can link up with him in Seattle, and saw this Filipino guy, short guy, him and another brother. And I saw his Metatown. So he wrote down, basically he was teaching first how to do it. And then actually did this message in the following week. Got me activated, and I haven't stopped since. It was since 2013 of December. And from 2014 till now, for 1 year, because of God's love, I've seen about 500 people healed.
Oh,
so that's it. Woo! That's how God used me. Used anyone. It's all in His name, it's all Him. Jesus is, that's what I try to tell people, Jesus is really alive, and He worked through ordinary things. So, that's my testimony, Jesus is awesome.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We just want to pray for brother. Be from
son feels that you're just called to ministry, and just release from the wonder of the world, and say, please, Holy Spirit, welcome to just more revelations. And just peace, your peace, knowing how to rest in the Father. Jesus.
Amen. Thank you.